Let us stand. Who gives this woman in marriage?
I am the mom.
Mis amados hermanos, que la gracia del Señor Jesucristo, el amor de Dios y la comunión del Espíritu Santo sea con todos vosotros. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of us this afternoon. Pueden tomar sus asientos. You can be seated. Feliz y sagrado es el momento cuando dos corazones consagrados se unen por los lazos del matrimonio. Holy and happy is the moment when two devoted hearts are joined in marriage. Lo más importante en la vida es amar a alguien. La segunda cosa más importante es que alguien le ame. Y la tercera cosa más importante es que las primeras dos se den al mismo tiempo. The most important thing in life is to love someone. The second most important thing in life is to have someone love you. And the third most important thing is to have the first two happen at the same time. Y esto fue lo que ocurrió con José y Teresa. Ahora están enamorados. Vienen a declararse públicamente su amor y lealtad y abrazar este estado honroso del matrimonio. This is what has happened to Jose and Teresa. They have fallen in love. They have come to make public their commitment to embrace their love and their loyalty in marriage. Es el deseo cordial de José y Teresa de recibirlos para que compartan y celebren este tiempo de adoración con ellos al llevar a cabo este pacto. It is the heartfelt desire of José and Teresa to welcome you, to share and celebrate their covenant and commitment of love during this time of worship. Ustedes han sido invitados para escuchar a José y Teresa mientras ellos prometen enfrentarse al futuro juntos y aceptando lo que les espere por delante. Now you all have been invited this afternoon to hear Jose and Teresa as they promise to face the future together and accepting whatever lies ahead. Al continuar con la ceremonia, vamos a pausar unos momentos y pedir la dirección de Dios. As we continue this ceremony, let's pause for a few seconds and let's go to God in prayer to ask His blessing for this wedding. Let us pray. Eternal God, we come before you, thanking you for this special day, for Jose and Teresa, as they are celebrating their wedding today. Lord, we ask your blessing upon each person here today. And Lord, we ask that you be our honored guest this afternoon. That everything we do, may it be of your approval. May you be with Jose and Teresa as they make this commitment of marriage today. May you bless this wedding. And we thank you, Lord, for the presence of everyone today. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Enseguida, next, I have some advice for Jose and Teresa. Tengo unos consejos para Jose y Teresa. I want to share with them some advice that will help them in marriage. In marriage, there is no shortcuts. I want you, Jose and Teresa, directly to both of you. I want to share with you what the Apostle Paul says in the Word of God, the Bible, about marriage. In chapter 5, verse 22, the Apostle here talks to wives and husbands. It says, wives, submit to your husband as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or other blemish, but holiness and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own body. He who loves his wives loves himself. After all, no one ever hated his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Now, in this marriage, each one of you husband and wife, brings a set of independent desires, independent thoughts, feelings, likes, and dislikes into the relationship. Jose and Teresa, excellent marriage don't happen by accident. They are achieved only by those who are willing to work towards a happy marriage. If you are willing to work towards a happy marriage, you will have a happy marriage. Both of you must build your marriage on a love that endures forever. And the type of love God has in mind is self-giving love. Now the husband should love his wife as Christ loved the church. The Apostle Paul just said it in the verses that I read. This type of love keeps on loving and loving. Just like the Duracell batteries, they just keep going on and on. And that's the way love should be. Just keep on giving. When it would be easier to walk away, you just keep on loving. It's a love which only death can terminate. It is a love that can handle deep trials because it is anchored in the will of God. Now, Jose and Teresa, keep the door open of communication. Being willing to talk and forgive one another. Don't hold grudges against one another. Now, I am sure that both of you want a happy home, a Christian home. And when Jesus lives in the home, when Jesus lives in the heart of the couple, that is the foundation for a happy home, when Jesus lives there. Prayer is a must for a happy home and a happy marriage. You must both pray. It is recommended that you pray together. In a happy home, there should be a Bible. Read the Bible together. Read and study your Bible, because the Bible speaks with authority concerning marriage. If there's a problem in your marriage, instead of running to your best friend, see what he can tell you, see what secret he got, run to that best friend that we have. What a friend we have in Jesus. Run to him, and he will tell you in the Bible where the solution is. The Bible is a marriage manual that can solve the problems that sometimes comes in marriage. Now, a good marriage, like I said, is not an accident. It is the results of husband and wife who love each other and commit themselves on building a good marriage. Commit yourself together. Now, both of you have voluntarily and faithfully chosen each other as partners in state matrimony. Now, both of you shall confess before God and before all these witnesses. I want you to turn around and look at all these witnesses here today. They are here today as witnesses to celebrate your marriage and to hear those words of that you will confess in marriage. And I see that you are already joined by your right hand. Now we will have the vows of marriage. Before taking the vows, I am going to ask Mr. and Mrs. Sergio and Loli Franco to come forward and put the rope, a lasso, on Jose and Teresa. Thank you. El lazo tiene su identificación. The rope has its significance. El lazo identifica la unión que no se rompe. Lo que Dios une, nadie lo puede romper en la tierra. The rope is the true lover's knot. It identifies the union that does not fall apart, and what God unites together, nobody on earth can break it up. Now we will do the vows. Inasmuch as you, Jose and Teresa, have expressed a desire to be united in marriage, I am going to ask you to take a vow that is made not only in the presence of your family and friends, but also in the presence of God. God is here with us this afternoon, and He is watching you and listening to what you are going to say. The Bible makes it clear that God is a witness to the wedding vows. He's a witness. I believe He is an unseen guest here today. He hears the vows you make, and He intends that they be kept so as long as you both shall live. Do you, Jose, take Teresa to be your lawfully wedded wife? And do you promise before God and these witnesses to love her, to comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so as long as you shall live? Do you promise?
I do.
And Teresa, do you take Jose to be your lawfully wedded husband? And do you promise before God and these witnesses to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you both shall live? Do you promise?
I do.
Jose, what do you give as a token of your love for Teresa? Jose, from time immemorial, the ring has been used to seal important covenants. When the human race was young and parliaments unknown, the great seals of state were fixed on rings worn by reigning monarchs, and its stamp was the sole sign of imperial authority. In later years, the days of the legendary King Arthur and his knights of the Round Table, France often exchanged simple bands of gold as enduring evidence of friendship and goodwill. But today, the ring has gained a far deeper meaning. It has become symbolic of a man's love for a woman, and a woman, and of a woman's love for a man. Jose, you will notice that this ring is a complete circle. It's a complete circle without beginning or end. It is symbolic, I trust, of the endlessness of your love for Teresa. Now, oh, they gave me the wrong ring. Now, Jose, you will take the ring. Place it on the third finger of Teresa's left hand. And as you place it there, hold it. Repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I do wed. And with all my worldly goods,
and with all my worldly goods,
I thee endow. In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and the Son,
and the Son,
and the Holy Ghost,
and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
And Teresa, what do you give as a token of your love for Jose? Okay, now I get the ring again. Okay.
The fireplace looks pretty, huh? Pretty shy.
Yeah. So what are you doing after this?
Think about taking you dance.
Teresa, you will notice that this ring is made of the purest of metals. It will not turn or tarnish with age. It is symbolic, and I trust of the purity of your love for Jose. You will take this ring and place it on the third finger of his left hand, and as you place it there, hold your hand there and repeat after me. With this ring,
I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods,
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Now, by the power vested in me by the state of Texas, and as a minister of the gospel, I now pronounce you husband and wife, and whatsoever God has joined together, let not the hand of man separate. You may now kiss the bride. Let us pause for a few minutes again and thank God for this beautiful marriage. Our Heavenly Father, once again we come before you to thank you for your presence, for the vows and the exchange of rings of this marriage. Lord, we pray for Jose and Teresa that you bless them in a very special way and give them many, many happy years of marriage. Be with them as they continue in this journey of marriage. Once again, Lord, we thank you. In the name of Jesus, amen. Now we will have the presentation of the Bible by Miss Nancy Prieto. Now the Bible Jose and Teresa is like a map. When you are lost on the road, most people look at the map, but now they Google it. They don't look at the map no more. But you will continue looking at the Bible. It says in Psalms 119, verse 105, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light for my path. The Bible is a light to your path. Read and study your Bible together. The Bible is the map you will need as you begin your new marriage. Treasure the Bible as a gift of God. Read your Bible, and believe me, you will see the blessings of the Lord. Now we will ask Mr. and Mrs. Sergio and Loli Franco to come and remove the rope from Jose and Teresa. Next, we will have the lighting of the unity candle by the parents. Vamos a encender la vela de unidad por los padres. The unity candle will be lighted. Le vamos a pedir que pasen la madre del novio y la madre de la novia. Now, each candle represents the life of the groom and the bride. La vida sin amor es como un árbol sin florecer y sin fruto. Y ahora les han dado tanto amor durante los años que vienen a compartir con ellos. Now life without love is like a tree without blossom and fruit. So it is now that we turn to the parents of these two that who have given so much love through the years. Ahora ustedes han expresado su amor en muchas maneras durante los años y lo hacen otra vez al encender la vela de unidad que ustedes están con ellos en amor en su matrimonio y en la formación de su nuevo hogar y su familia. Now you have expressed your love in so many ways through the years. And once again, you do so by lighting the unity candle, stating that you are with them in love, in marriage, and the formation of their new home. Pueden encender la vela. Al ver encendido la vela de unidad, ustedes como madres prometen sus oraciones y bendiciones sobre José y Teresa. As you have lighted the unity candle, you promise your prayers and your blessings upon José and Teresa. Hermana González, hermana Prieto, que Dios les bendiga en esta bendita promesa que han hecho. May God bless both of you on this blessed promise that you have made today. Gracias, hermana González y hermana Prieto. Enseguida tenemos, we have the lighting of the unity candle by the groom and the bride. Now, as the unity candle is lighted by Jose and Teresa, may it be an inspiration for both of you. Jose and Teresa, by the vows and promise you both have made, you have demonstrated your desire to unite in holy matrimony with the blessings of God. The Bible teaches that in marriage, both of you become one flesh by symbolism of this sect as you have lighted the unity candle. Enseguida vamos a encender la vela de unidad familiar. Next we will be lighting the lighting of the family unity candles by the children. I will ask Zachary, Jayden, Noah, and Mary to come forward. Often marriage is viewed as the union of two persons. But when children are present in marriage, it is more than the union of two persons. It is the proclaiming of a new family. As the children have lighted the family unity candles, from the lighted candles of Jose and Teresa, it pledges the love to their children that is being brought into the marriage. As a symbol for family unity, love, and responsibility. Jose and Teresa, you have both pledged today before God and all these witnesses your loving support and protection for your children. May God bless all six of you. this comes to the conclusion of this wedding. After the wedding ceremony, you all are invited to the reception. So let us pray once again. Vamos a orar una vez más. Altísimo Dios y buen Padre, te damos las infinitas gracias, Padre, por esta nueva pareja que hoy, Padre bendito, se han unido en los lazos del matrimonio. Bendícelos, Padre, de una forma muy especial. Bendíceles su familia, a sus hijos, padre y hija. Bendice el hogar que van a formar y que tú seas con ellos en todo momento. Y que nada ni nada, Padre bendito, los desanime en el camino y que en todo momento busquen por la dirección eterna para seguir adelante en su matrimonio. Bendíceles, Padre. Y gracias te damos, Padre, por esta tarde donde hemos celebrado la boda de matrimonio de José y Teresa. Now I present to you Mr. and Miss José and Teresa Prieto and family.
I live a lifetime every moment when I'm holding you close. Lay your head down on my shoulder, honey, I won't ever let go. Because you pulled me like a magnet, now I'm right where I belong. I'm gonna love you the same for the rest of my days, and on and on and on. Cause as long as we keep dancing, we'll stay young at heart. And every time I hold you in my arms, you give me deja vu. Like I've been waiting my whole life to find that you. Cause when I'm looking at your eyes, I go from California to Timbuktu, back to dancing in the living room. If I got you, baby, every day's a honeymoon. It's a honeymoon. Baby, every day's a honeymoon. I wanna spend some time in Paris, serenade you on the beach. We'll take a picture for our parents, but we're never gonna leave. Nobody knows you like I know you. Nobody loves you like I do. And if I'm never a star, but I got my guitar, I'll be singing songs to you. Cause as long as we keep dancing, we'll stay young at heart. And every time I hold you in my arms, you give me deja vu. Like I've been waiting my whole life to find that you. Cause when I'm looking at your eyes, I go from California to Timbuktu, back to dancing in the living room. If I got you, baby, every day's a honeymoon. Thank you.
kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. That every long lost stream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars.
Thank you. thank all of you for coming out. I really have to get you all here. I just love the support from all of our friends and our family. We love you guys so much. You all had a big part in helping us get this together and everything like that. And I just can't thank you all enough for being here and help us celebrate this. I love this guy so much. And he's just been a... Hello? as I was saying, Jose has just been a true blessing to me and to my family and to my kids. And I just want to say thank you again so much for being here with us today.
Well, I don't even know where to start. I just feel like I have the most amazing friends and family. I really do. I'm so blessed and lucky to have this special day with this lovely, beautiful bride of mine now. I can finally say that, right? I'm so excited about it. I just want to say thank you to everyone that was involved in making this happen. It couldn't happen without it. It takes so many hands, so much help to put this together. It's just such a blessing. My cousin Mark, thank you so much. The Brisket, the Forrest family, with the Asado, and all my aunts and friends that helped with it. From the macaroni salad to the beans to you name it. It's been amazing. I'm truly blessed, thankful for every one of y'all. This day is only special because everybody is here. That's how I feel. It's an amazing feeling to have everybody here. Your mom for the cake, and my sister for that wonderful cake over there, shining those indie colors. I'm just really, really blessed. Thank y'all for everything. We'll be around again to shake your hands and hug your necks, and you know, we love you with all of our hearts, and I'm truly blessed. I'm very excited to enjoy the rest of my life with this beautiful woman, and thank y'all. Let's have a good time.
We got a couple more beer, or two glasses.
Like Gracie said, we love Teresa very much, and we're so happy she found Jose. And you guys are just wonderful. Y'all have the true meaning of love, so we wish y'all the best. And if everybody would like to toast to the bride and groom.
Anybody else? Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Sorry?
The best man?
My brother never talks to my girls, ever. And then he calls me in 2013. Hey, bro, I made this girl. I knew. And then she went to Notre Dame game. We knew she was a keeper. Congratulations. Nothing but happiness. Well, then we have great special kids, special life. That's how we enjoy it.
I just want to tell the ladies that I love her very much. My man, a wonderful man. And I wish you the best of luck. And I love you both. Thank you very much. And I'm not an old man now.
With all that said, thank you again, everybody, for being here. We love you all. It's been an awesome night. It's going to continue to be. Cheers.